So hello everyone and very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of ARD Current Affairs. So I hope guys your preparations are going well and these sessions are helping you in your preparations. So Monday, Wednesday and Friday I am coming with the session on government schemes, and on Tuesday there is a weekly session on ARD Current Affairs. Now ARD Current Affairs guys, isko aap please halke mein mat lena. It is equally important for your upcoming NABARD examination. सो आई ट्राई कि जितना ज्यादा से ज्यादा आपका एआरडी करंट अफेयर्स पूरा हो पाएगा मैं कराऊंगा, ठीक है. इनफैक्ट सारा कंप्लीट हो जाएगा, डोंट यू वरी. जब तक एग्जाम आपका आएगा जितना भी एआरडी करंट अफेयर्स है एवरीथिंग विल बी कवर्ड. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट टुडे सेशन. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एज द एग्जामिनेशन दिस ईयर यू कैन ज्वाइन दी लाइव क्लास कोर्स ऑफ नबार्ड विच हैज स्टार्टेड एंड अभी क्रैश कोर्स भी लॉन्च हो गया है. तो यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दैट बाय विजिटिंग anujindal.in. And if you want to have the all-round preparation of your examination, you can download the Anujindal app from the Google Play Store. Alright, and now let's move ahead to the very first question, which says, which institute of ICAR, which is Indian Council of Agriculture Research, has observed centenary year celebration? So, वह साल की celebration कौन से institute ने अभी celebrate की है? Right? वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इफ आई टॉक अबाउट दी एआरडी सेक्शन, ठीक है. देखो इसी तरीके के क्वेश्चन आते हैं एआरडी करंट में, कोई ऐसा कुछ अनोखा क्वेश्चन नहीं आएगा एआरडी में से, राइट. कि ये सांप का बच्चा यहाँ पे कहाँ पे पैदा हुआ, इस तरीके का क्वेश्चन नहीं आता, ठीक है. बेसिक क्वेश्चन आते हैं जो कि इसी टाइप के होते हैं. सो विच इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ICAR हैज ऑब्जर्व सेंटिनरी ईयर सेलिब्रेशन? दिस इंस्टीट्यूट गाइज इज नेशनल डेयरी रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट विच इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन करनाल. सो नो वंडर कि आपको एग्जाम में यही पूछ लिया जाए कि वेयर इज द या वेयर आर द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ दिस नेशनल डेयरी रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट. सो द आंसर इन दैट केस वुड बी करनाल. बट दिस टाइम द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर इनॉग्रेटेड द सेंटिनरी ईयर सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ नेशनल डेयरी रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट विच इज लोकेटेड इन करनाल. बट दैट इज नॉट इनफ, वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट एनडीआरआई एज वेल. एनडीआरआई के बारे में आपको बेसिक्स पता होने चाहिए, राइट. सो रिमेंबर इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1923 as Imperial Institute for Animal Husbandry and Dairying and in Bengaluru. ठीक है, पहले कहां पे establish हुआ था? ये बेंगलुरु में. बट इन द ईयर 1955 द हेडक्वार्टर्स वर ट्रांसफर टू करनाल. ठीक है, इट वॉज इनिशियली नेम्ड एज वॉट? इंपीरियल इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग, राइट. और 1955 में इसका हेडक्वार्टर कहां पे शिफ्ट हो गया? करनाल में. एंड इन 1970 इट वॉज ब्रॉट अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ ICAR एंड देन इट वॉज रीनेम्ड एज NDRI, National Dairy Research Institute. Remember, this institute has the distinction of being a deemed university. ये एक deemed university भी है, along with a research institution for implementing its academic programs since the year 1989. So it is not only a research institute, it is also a deemed university because it is delivering its academic programs since the year 1989. And it provides high quality education in the field of dairying, which has no parallel इन एशिया. एशिया में इस तरीके का रिसर्च इकोसिस्टम इन द एरिया ऑफ डेयरी कहीं पे भी नहीं है. एंड यू विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू नो दिस दैट NDRI में महात्मा गांधी ने भी ट्रेनिंग ली थी, ठीक है. महात्मा गांधी ने भी इस इंस्टीट्यूट में ट्रेनिंग ली थी, राइट. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट? ऑप्शन सी, नेशनल डेयरी रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. Where has Department of Food and Public Distribution organized a national conference on food and nutrition security in India? कहाँ पे ये conference organize किया गया था? And it was conducted by Department of Food and Public Distribution, which is of course under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, and this ministry is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, who is also the Minister of Commerce and Industry, and the Minister of Textiles as well, and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. He is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. So where this conference has been organized? So remember, it has been organized in New Delhi. ठीक है, कहाँ पे organized हुआ था? New Delhi में, with an aim to facilitate the cross learning and disseminating best practices for schemes under the public distribution system. जो public distribution system में best practices follow हो रही हैं, उसके बारे में जानकारी देना, उसके बारे में discussion करना, that was the objective of this conference, right? The discussions involved these areas. The key areas of discussion were these: food fortification, diversification of food basket, क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन इंटीग्रेटेड अन्न वितरण पोर्टल 2.0 जो कि अभी लॉन्च हुआ नहीं है, होगा, राइट, एंड रिफॉर्म्स इन पीडीएफ एंड स्टोरेज सेक्टर. नाउ दीज की एरियाज ऑफ डिस्कशन, इट इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन, इट इज जस्ट फॉर द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट वॉट डिस्कशन वर हेल्ड ड्यूरिंग दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस, राइट. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज वॉट, न्यू डेली, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, दिस आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इन पीआईबी 247 सेशंस एज वेल, बट यस इट इज रिक्वायर्ड हेयर ऑल्सो, बिकॉज ये क्वेश्चन तो आना ही आना है. अगर ये क्वेश्चन नहीं आता है तो वो क्वेश्चन पेपर बेकार है, उसको करना ही मत, छोड़ देना. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू स्टेट रैंकिंग इंडेक्स फॉर एनएफएसए 2022. सो दिस इज फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम दैट द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हैज लॉन्च्ड सच रैंकिंग बेस्ड ऑन द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ एनएफएसए इन द रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज, राइट. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस इंडेक्स एंड देन वी विल कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. It is the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution which has launched it. Please remember this. It is not the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and not the Ministry of Commerce and Industry as well. ठीक है? And this index represents the status and progress of the implementation of NFSA and various reforms which are undertaken by the states and UTs to ensure better public distribution system. Right? Talking about the index, so this index is largely focused on NFSA distribution and in future, it will include procurement and Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana distribution as well, right? It is built on 3 pillars which are NFSA coverage, targeting and provisions of the act, delivery platform and nutrition initiative. So these are the 3 key pillars on which this index is based. And now, talking about the ranking, so the states are categorized into 3 parts. Number 1 states are general states, number 2 are special states and UTs, general states and UTs, and then we have UTs operating in DBT mode. What are these UTs operating in DBT mode? So there are 3 UTs in the country, which are these: Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, Puducherry and Chandigarh, where this NFSA is implemented in the DBT cash transfer mode. Now, what is the meaning of DBT cash transfer mode? Basically, in these 3 UTs, the beneficiaries are not getting the food grains under this act. Rather, they are getting the amount in their bank accounts through the DBT transfer, and with the help of that amount, they are buying the food grains from the market. Okay? So basically, they are not getting the food grains, they are getting the amount for that food grains, and with the help of that amount, they can buy the food grains from the market, right? And this amount is given in the DBT cash transfer mode directly to their bank accounts, right? So among general states and UTs, Odisha has been ranked number 1, followed by UP and Andhra Pradesh. Among special states and UTs, it is Tripura which has been ranked number 1, followed by Himachal Pradesh and Sikkim. And among UTs operating in DBT mode, number 1 pe we have Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, followed by Puducherry and Chandigarh. Okay, so now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the incorrect statement. All right, it is the first ever state ranking index for NFSA. Bilkul sahi baat hai, no problem with this, right? The states have been categorized into 3 categories. Absolutely correct, no problem. Among general category of states and UTs, UP has been ranked number 1. No, not UP. It is Odisha which was ranked number 1. So this must be the correct answer, guys, to this question, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. Moving ahead to question number 4, and there are total 10 questions today. To which family dragon fruit belongs? So you must be wondering, it is a session of ART current affairs, then why are you talking about this question? Because dragon fruit is in news. That is why this question is here. All right. Now why dragon fruit is in news, by the way? It is in news because a national conclave on dragon fruit, which our government calls Kamlam as well. Kamlam, theek hai? Kamlam matlab kamal ho gaya, lotus, right? So, a national conclave on dragon fruit or Kamlam was organized under the chairpersonship of a secretary under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. And this conclave was organized by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare only, right? Now, why this was organized? To give a boost to increase the area, production and productivity, marketing, branding, etc. etc. of dragon fruit in the country. Okay? A technical session was also conducted to address the issues which are there with respect to the production, with respect to the production of dragon fruit in the country. ठीक है. इसके अलावा if I talk about the dragon fruit, so remember its scientific name is Selenicerius undatus. Selenicerius undatus is the scientific name. It is a species of family Cactaceae and it is used as an ornamental vine and as a fruit crop. ठीक है. So ये question आपके exam में पूछा जा सकता है, to which family it belongs, and therefore the correct answer is option E, Cactaceae is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5. Niti Aayog in collaboration with which of the following organizations has organized initiative on mainstreaming millets in Asia and Africa? And I hope you all know this, that 2023 will be observed as International Year of Millets. International Year of Millets, right? By United Nation. ठीक है. And what is the United Nation International Year 2022? Can you tell me that? Write down in the comment section. This question is for you. Now this initiative on mainstreaming millets in Asia and Africa was organized by Niti Aayog in collaboration with World Food Program. Option D is the correct answer. And remember, World Food Program is headquartered in Rome, which is of course the capital of Italy. Question number 6. On which date the 22nd National Fish Farmers Day was observed at National Fisheries Development Board, which is located in Hyderabad? Now here in this question you have to remember two things. First of all, when was the National Fish Farmers Day observed? So it was observed on 10th of July. That's it. Option A is the correct answer. And second thing you have to remember, the National Fisheries Development Board is located in Hyderabad. ठीक है. इस तरीके के भी questions आते हैं. The organizations related to the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Food Processing Industry, Rural Development, Panchayati Raj. इनसे related अगर कोई organizations हैं तो उनके headquarters भी हमें याद रखने पड़ेंगे. Like Spices Board का headquarter कहाँ पे है, Rubber Board का headquarter कहाँ पे है, Tea Board, Coffee Board, there are various boards in the country, right? The correct answer is 10th of July. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 7. Who has inaugurated the first ever India Animal Health Summit 2022 organized by Indian Chamber of Food and Agriculture? Now this was the first ever India Animal Health Summit. However, there is iske andar kuch zyada cheeze padhne ke liye thi nahi. There were only the discussions regarding how animal health can be a boon, matlab how the focus on animal health can help us in boosting the economy, right? So it was the first ever India Animal Health Summit. It was organized by Indian Chamber of Food and Agriculture in collaboration with Agriculture Today Group, right? For discussing the significance of animal health towards the broader objective of country's food and nutrition security, rural incomes and prosperity, and overall economic development, right? So who has inaugurated it? It was inaugurated by Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Who is the minister, by the way? It's Mr. Purushottam Rupala. Right? Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 8. With which of the following organizations, IC, Indian Council for Research on International Economic Relations, has organized a conference on getting agricultural markets right? Now, agar aapne ye question pehle nahi padha hoga, definitely you will mark wrong answer, because jo iska answer hai, wo kahin se bhi guess nahi kiya ja sakta. Right? So this, what is the name? Getting Agricultural Markets Right. The conference was organized by Indian Council for Research on International Economic Relation in collaboration with National Stock Exchange. Yes, the correct answer is not Niti Aayog, not DPIIT, not ICAR, not IARI. It's National Stock Exchange, which is the correct answer. And that is why this question becomes important. Question number 9. Which of the following institutes of ICAR has received Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi and Rajarshi Tandon Rajbhasha Award? Now, the details of these awards are not important. We are discussing it because this award has been won by one of the institutes of ICAR, and that is why it is related to the agriculture, right? It is Central Research Institute for Jute and Allied Fibers, which has got this award, Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi and Rajarshi Tandon Rajbhasha Award. Option A is the correct answer. And guys, the last question for today, according to publication titled Doubling Farmers' Income, this question is very, very important. आई बिलीव ये क्वेश्चन आपके एग्जाम में होना चाहिए. अकॉर्डिंग टू द पब्लिकेशन टाइटल्ड डबलिंग फार्मर्स इनकम रिलीज एट 94th फाउंडेशन डे ऑफ ICAR, विच स्टेट्स फार्मर रिकॉर्डेड हाइएस्ट इंक्रीज इन इनकम अमंग ऑल द स्टेट्स इन द कंट्री. कौन से स्टेट में सबसे ज्यादा इंक्रीज इन इनकम हुआ है फार्मर्स का अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट विच इज टाइटल्ड एज डबलिंग फार्मर्स इनकम. सो दिस स्टेट इन क्वेश्चन गाइस इज वेस्ट बंगाल. ऑप्शन सी, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ अ स्कीम विच इज बींग इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल एंड दैट इज कृषक बंधु स्कीम. राइट, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Alright, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions and their explanation and answers are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And tomorrow there will be a session on government schemes. Please don't go anywhere. Every Monday, Wednesday and Friday, 5 PM government scheme. Every Tuesday, 5 PM a session on ARD current affairs. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye, take care and God bless.